Jeff and Jeremy in the morning.
Are you starting to feel it? Who's had their first peppermint mocha? Cameron.
Aloha.
Aloha. Aloha. Do you, or a gingerbread latte. Anybody have a gingerbread latte yet? Peppermint mocha?
We have a new sponsor coming to the show next week. We're actually going to play a game on Monday, but we'll get to that on Monday. It's called a human bean.
Oh, I know.
And
human bean.
It's a weird name, but apparently the coffee is fantastic.
And they give you a little chocolate covered coffee bean.
Oh, that's old school.
But no, it's only old school to you and I because the place that we went to college, the little coffee shop there,
the Daily Grind,
they did that.
Well, they did in the West Side too.
Where?
Seattle's Best used to do it. Those little coffee stands and some of the other little.
By the way,
ones.
Seattle's Best is the biggest fake news.
Yeah.
Just in the name.
Well, Seattle was known for the coffee scene because of Starbucks and Tully's, and then Seattle's Best came in thinking they would just call it Seattle's Best.
Yeah, we're just going to call this
it
Seattle's
really
Best,
was not the best
Folgers.
Of Seattle. I don't even know if it's still around or not. It probably is. But I heard the coffee bean is good, and what, does it start on Monday?
Yeah. Wait.
And we're giving away...
We're going to give away a $25 gift card to...
Every Monday.
But
coffee for the week, man.
They have a white chocolate peppermint mocha right now.
Mm-hmm.
And then you get that added little coffee bean with it's covered in chocolate. And the cool thing is it's covered in chocolate, but it's white and brown chocolate. That makes it so yummy. I don't know what it is. And I would never eat a coffee bean on its own, but when it's covered with chocolate, something about it. It's just so good, you know?
So good.
Anyways.
I love the richness of the holidays. The foods.
I know.
The drinks.
But I look like Tim Allen in the...
Yeah, the waist is
in
the problem.
The claws, man. I'm telling you. I just cinched my belt today. I've had good willpower in the past. Right now, I don't have good willpower. I don't know what it is. But it's I gotta rein it in. I gotta get control of it, man.
I know.
I'm up to 214 now.
I'm not weighing myself anymore. I'm just unbuttoning
buttons.
Before
Thanksgiving, I was down to 208.
I'm just unbuttoning
things. I'm in 190, and here I'm bouncing back and forth between 214 and 208.
Yeah, you'll be all right.
Beef. No, I won't.
You'll get there. You'll be fine.
I think you're rooting against me.
I'm not rooting against you. I mean, I'd like you to be fatter than me, and then I could start calling you fat, so like you call me. I mean, it doesn't hurt my feelings. I'm fine.
Come on, move it.
It's the holidays. This is what we do. It's our winter coat. It's what we do. Whitney will be joining us later on. We'll be get updated on what's going on downtown. Jeff tells me there's a lot going on downtown for the holidays. Would you say there's almost feels like there's more going on than in years past?
No. But I will say that there's...
See, because I don't remember Mission Plaza, all this stuff happening. They just had Santa there.
That is an upgrade. Yeah. That is an upgrade. But, I mean, you can't...
There's no parade this Friday.
We're missing the parade.
But outside of that,
awesome.
But I'm talking about just downtown, which is there all the time. Anyway, she'll tell us about it. But they have a lot going on. Displays. There's still plenty of ways to enjoy downtown. She'll join us coming up at 7:30.
Anything you can do to get the kids out to celebrate it and make it as normal as possible is going to help out. I was talking to my mom yesterday, but I have a niece. And it's very, like, you know, I know we gripe about Gavin Newsom and stuff like that, but we're pretty lucky here on the Central Coast where we're not living in a metropolitan area. Like, if we lived in Santa Clara County right now, I mean, it's basically on lockdown. I mean, they said, you know, they told the 49ers. They said, Niners, you can't play here anymore. You got to go to Arizona. Sorry. We're not having any contact sports. So that goes across the board. So basically, people are having to stay inside their house. And it's somewhat the same in Seattle and especially where my niece lives because she lives in the city. And I was talking to her about my niece, and she said, you know, this is really having an effect on her. It's you know, she's an introvert now. She used to be... You know, run around, meet
invite her down here,
stuff like that.
There's your moment to be the best uncle ever. Say, hey, she can come stay with us for a couple weeks.
Yeah, I know. I'll be just an uncle over that.
You have an opportunity to be selfless and to do something great for someone else. Just saying, you have an opportunity. It's not too late.
Yeah, they've never offered that to take my kids. Well, so, you know,
you can be the bigger person.
I wouldn't mind it from a standpoint that I could hang it over their head for a long time. But my kids.
Think about that. It's a lifetime of hanging it over their head. It's family. They're never going away. They're going
to. I love my kids too much to expose them to that much patchouli on a trip.
KZOZ.com, and if you saw the news yesterday, but Bob Barker, the Bob Barker's Price is Right is getting its own channel. It's getting its own channel on that app that you like so much, Pluto TV.
Yes.
And
Pluto's awesome for game
shows. Is it Fremantle? Is that how I've never heard of it before.
Fremantle Media. So what they did is
it's spelled F-R-E-M.
Yeah. Fremantle Media bought a bunch of the rights to a bunch of old game shows. So basically Buzzer Network on Pluto is all Fremantle stuff, but it's all old game shows. And they probably bought them for next to nothing. But they know from the success of the Game Show Network that now there's so many places you could put stuff. There's enough interest out there for, old game shows. I love watching the old game shows.
Oh yeah, they're the best. And I honestly think Bob Barker deserves this. In my opinion, he's the best game show host of all time.
So I remember sixth grade summer. Wait, was it fifth grade summer? Sixth grade summer, going away for a while and coming back, and Bob Barker's hair went from black to white. And I was, what happened to Bob? What's going on? It was very hard for me. I didn't know that he colored for so many years.
Well, I don't think a lot of people, once you saw the white, you realized it. But I mean, it was a dramatic effect.
Yes. I mean, it made him look a lot older. But when you go from black to white hair, in an instant like that, it's very hard. Is this channel on Pluto with Bob Barker Price is Right going to feature black-haired Bob and white-haired Bob?
From 1972 to 2007.
Yeah!
he received a Lifetime Achievement Award in 1999. He's been there a long time. And I know Pat Sajak would be probably up for consideration. Of course, Alex Trebek right now, people would say. But when I think of game show host, that's the one I think of most. Mm-hmm. Now, you're a big game show host guy. You know all the guys.
No, I don't know all of them.
I mean, you know Card Sharks, and you know Joker's Wild, and what was the wedding? What was the Newlywed Game? And yes. There's the guy we talked to that did
Bob
the Rose
Eubanks.
Bowl parade. Bob
down.
Eubanks.
Yeah,
Bob
down.
Eubanks is up there.
I think he lives on like Los Olivos or something.
Cameron, do you watch any game shows?
Yeah.
You do? I like game shows. Do you? I mean, current or the old school, like reruns of game shows? Like, we had so many in the 80s.
I'll say right now, new game shows suck. They're terrible.
Yeah.
They're not good.
I don't know. Did you ever watch Jerry Springer's Baggage?
Yes, I do like that one. But that's on Game Show Network.
I love that one.
Yeah,
I
it's
want
pretty
that
good.
To come back.
I've never heard of that. So, because it's on the Game Show Network only.
It's kind
so
of a dating
pretty
show.
Niched.
Oh, okay. It's kind of a dating show. And
Jerry Springer.
Wait, break it down for me, because it's been a while since I've seen Baggage.
Like,
what's the premise on Baggage?
Okay, so there's it's either one girl or one guy, and then three girls or three guys.
So it's like the dating game. It's set up
like
that.
Yeah, and it's but essentially like instead of say like the dating game where it's like, oh yeah, I'm into this and this, and they're trying to sell themselves. They sell themselves, and then it's like, okay, open your baggage, boys. And then they open it, and then it'll say something like, oh, I vape, or I have a tramp stamp, or something that's supposed to turn the person
awesome.
Off. And then they kick him off, and then whoever's makes it last.
Somebody ever, like, come on, like, said, yeah, he's got seven kids.
Yeah. No, and that's how it happens.
Five babies mamas.
Stuff like that happens on that show. It's amazing.
That sounds
and
great.
Only Jerry Springer can host that.
I would have never thought of Jerry Springer as a game show host. I mean, he's always a talk show host.
Oh, he does a great job.
It was fantastic.
No, it's a good show.
He's really good at that.
They played a lot,
too. He's really great with dealing with trash. Just trash. Him and Maury. Maury. I mean, those are the two, like, my favorite two daytime talk shows, but it's hard to find Maury anymore. But
should we build the SurfNet communication?
This is what I was thinking, yeah.
Poll question around this today? Because, I mean, I think...
I was thinking about game show hosts, but maybe you just want to put up game shows. I don't know. There's so many. But.
Ooh, this is a problem. Okay, so give us a list. Okay, so... the guy that I think of, because he hosted so many shows, and I always forget his name. He hosted Card Sharks. He hosted Sale of the Century. He hosted, so many. Oh, Jim Perry. That's why, because he's got a very forgettable name. Jim Perry. You would know Jim Perry.
If you saw his face, right?
Yeah. The lead singer of Journey.
Who said that? I recognize him.
They should have done that once on Sale of the Century. Just Steve Perry comes walking out. He's like, hey, I'm hosting today, guys. How's it going?
Who's the guy in the pyramid? $25,000,
$100,000? Dick Clark.
Chuck, oh. It was Chuck Woolery, wasn't it?
No, it was Dick Clark.
Oh, it was Dick Clark and then Chuck Woolery?
Well, Chuck Woolery was Love Connection, and he did some other shows as well.
Okay, but Chuck would go up there. Dick Clark definitely has to go up there.
Jim Perry.
Okay. Bob Eubanks.
Yes.
Robert.
Gene Rayburn. I mean, there's a list.
Yeah, obviously you're going to have Pat, you're going to have Bob, and you're going to have Alex.
I apologize. Normally I would be writing this down as I'm going along, but we need to compile a list. Okay, so maybe what we should do is...
We'll come back to this.
Let's take a quick break. Come back with what we think is a comprehensive list, and then if you want to text anybody in right now, 805 text lines.
Wait, what number did you just give?
805-543-3693.
What was the number you just gave?
I don't know.
Something 13.
I don't
know.
Is
that your cell phone?
I don't know.
If you got it, you got it. Jeff just gave out his cell phone. 805-543-3693.
Edit that out of the podcast.
Jeff and Jeremy here. It's KZOZ. We've already getting in big arguments here.
Jeremy thinks that there's too many.
15 is too many on the poll. We need to narrow it to top 10. Jeff, come on. You know that.
Think how much better this country would be if you had 15 choices for president of the United States of America. We wouldn't have this, stop the steal or anything like that. We'd just be like, oh, well, that guy got the most votes.
All right. Cameron, since you're the youngest of the show by generations, at least a generation below us, give me your top three, or just the top three game show hosts that pop into your head that you think should be on this list. At least, or you can go five if you have five.
All right, so number three, Steve Harvey.
Okay.
Number two, Steve Harvey.
Oh, my God.
Number one, Steve
Harvey. See, we hate Steve Harvey. Hate Steve Harvey.
I hate you.
I mean, you know, listen, he does an adequate job on The Family Feud.
No, he doesn't.
He does an adequate. Well, who else are they going to get?
Compared to Ray Combs, compared to Richard Dawson.
Richard Dawson has to be on this list.
Well, yeah,
I am sorry.
He is
He's a freaking legend, okay?
And I think you got to put Ray Combs on there, too.
All right, sorry. Sometimes I ask a young person something, and then as soon as finish the sentence, I'm like, why the hell did I ask him that out loud?
Okay, all right. I'll give you my real one. I'll give you my real three.
Oh, shut up. That is your real three. I want your honest opinion.
No.
Okay. Just doing that to mess with us because you knew we hated Steve Harvey?
Probably.
Yeah, I did.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I don't like Steve Harvey either. But
all right, you're saying
his show is trash, and he's kind of gross as a human being. But, all right, so number three would be the guy from the pyramid. What was it, like 25,000, then it was 50, and then it was 100?
Dick Clark?
Yeah, Dick
you
Clark.
You can't remember Dick Clark's name? Oh, my God.
Jeremy's really,
it was on late at night. I didn't remember his name. I didn't care enough. Number two would be Jerry Springer on Baggage. And number one has to be Bob Barker.
Okay. So I think Barker's on there.
You gotta see my list over here. It's great.
I think Barker's on there. I think Sajak is on there. Dawson is on there. Dick Clark is definitely on there. I have to keep. See, I can't write.
What
this
about
fast.
Howie Mandel?
No.
That was one of the most popular game shows.
Bob Eubanks.
All he did was have models open boxes.
Howie Mandel's terrible, dude.
Howie Mandel is boring.
Monty Hall? Monty Hall.
No, I know.
How are you not going to put Monty Hall on there?
I am.
Cameron's like, who the hell is Monty Hall?
I've heard of Monty Python.
Maybe he hasn't. You want to know
who's going on this list, Jeremy? Okay. This is going to take me a while to build this.
Regis Philbin. Much better than Baldy. Much better.
Who's Baldy? Steve Harvey?
No. Well, yes. And the guy you just brought up. He's on America's Got Talent now, a judge.
Oh, Howie Mandel.
Howie Mandel. Regis Philbin was a great game show host. I mean, think about it. The only reason Millionaire is still on is because of Regis Philbin.
True. I guess. I don't know.
Chuck Woolery, 2-2.
You want to know the list? Here's the list, okay? Give me a second, and I might need a drink of water or something halfway through this thing. Okay, it is a marathon.
I can't write
this. Is what I have.
I'll get a hand.
This is what I have, okay?
Alex Trebek.
I have Alex Trebek. Bob. I have Pat Sajak. I have Gene Rayburn. I have Richard Dawson. Monty Hall.
Stop on Gene Rayburn. What did he do?
Match Game? Match Game was phenomenal.
Okay, yes. I remember him. I just couldn't remember what he did. That's right. Match Game.
Yes. Bert Convy.
He lives on Sesame Street, dumbass.
Wink Martindale. Bill Cullen. Alan Ludden.
Hold on. Slow down.
Password.
Wait.
Password.
Alan who?
Alan Ludden was Betty White's wife. I mean, husband.
He comes in number 13 on Ranker's top game show hosts. Yes. He did, what did he do?
The Password. He was the original Password host.
Okay.
Password was great.
Yeah, that's amazing. Wink Martindale, Tic Tac Doe. Uh-huh. Steve Harvey, Ray Combs, rest in peace, Ray.
Ray Combs, no.
Ray Combs was awesome. In fact, I like Ray Combs at.
Is Pat Sajak on there?
Family Feud better than Richard Dawson.
You haven't said Richard Dawson yet.
Richard Dawson's on there.
Okay.
I got him there.
How many people? How many do you have there? How many? What's your total number? It's got to be more than 15. Oh, okay, you have 20 over 20.
24.
That we can't put that many on the poll.
Jim Perry, Bob Eubanks, Chuck Woolery, Bob Barker, Drew Carey, Dick Clark.
Forget it. I'm out.
See, this is the problem with America.
No.
You want two choices.
No.
And that's what that leads to.
No, I want 10 choices.
He wants two choices.
I want a top
Steve
10
Harvey,
list.
Steve
I don't
do,
want
why
21.
Why do we need to be pigeonholed at the top? If we really want to know who the best game show host is of all time.
Listen, participation maybe, trophy maybe boy. Ellen Listen, not members. Everybody needs a trophy just because you hosted a game show. Why don't you put Betty White on there? For God's sake.
She's on the list.
God, I hate you. Can't you just narrow it down to 10? That's all I want. I think it's reasonable. What, are we going to have 21 people on our poll? I don't even think our website, I know it's a piece of crap, it doesn't support 21
What about your
answers.
Next-door neighbor, Mark Summers? I mean, come on, Double Dare? I mean, this is a great, great show.
Okay, send them in now, all right? You could do a top 10, or you can just give us, you know, your top 3 or whatever you want, 805-543-3693. We're going to have to compile. This is going to take us some time, and we'll relaunch this at 8 o'clock this morning.
Subscribe to the Jeff and Jeremy podcast now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google, and YouTube. It's your Central Coast commute-friendly podcast.